Part of the video, and I'm going to be emphasizing on the concept which I've said in my first part of the video. We are finding what is the probability of getting a tail in the both tosses. This is what I'm saying. From my tree diagram, you can see that you have the chance here, because you're saying it is you get the tail in the first toss and the tail in the second toss. So from my tree diagram, you can be able to see this one is going to be probability of getting a tail and a tail. This one is going to be given by what? In the first toss you get a tail, that is a half. In the second toss you get a tail, multiplied by a half. This one is going to be 1 over 4. That is the concept which I'm trying to talk about. But if not that, you can do good content. Out of this one, how many are they? You have a list of the possible number of the outcome, there are 4 of them. So out of the 4, which one is favorite? Tail and tail. So it's going to be 1 out of how many? Out of 1 over 4. But because I want to emphasize on this low case of the probability, that's why I'm emphasizing on the concept using a tree diagram in this case, so that you can be able to see them. This one is going to be a half multiplied by a half. Then at the end of the day, you are seeing that is the case of getting what? The probability in both tosses. Then there are some of the keywords that I want to emphasize. That was the one of them. So what is, what if? The question asks if, what is the probability of getting at least, that is B, let's say that is B, at least a head. So that one means what? When you say the word at least, so I want to emphasize on the concept of this at least, which means at least a hill. So this one is going to be 4. So meaning, this one means from 1 and above, from 1 and above. So if I say what is the probability of getting at least a hill, the probability of getting at least a hill. So meaning this one can be given by what? That is one head and above, from 1 and above. So meaning you can be able to get this one, whereby you have this going to be probability of, in the first toss you get a head, in the second one you get a tail. Or, not that way, in the first toss you get a tail, probability you get a tail. Then in the second tails you get a head. Or if not that way, then you get probability. In the first tails you get a head, and then in the second one you get a head. Because you're saying the word at least, it means one and above. That is another idea that technique is going to be used during the exam. So you must be very keen on this. In this case you're going to see, this one is going to be given by what? This one, head and tail, we have here head. And tail is going to be a half multiplied by a half. It's going to be a half multiplied by a half, then all, that is addition, again, this one tail and head, that's going to be tail and head, so it is a half multiplied by a half, it's going to be a half multiplied by a half, then again plus, the probability of getting head and head, that's going to be a half multiplied by a half. So in a nutshell, you can see, you're going to have this one is going to be 1 over 4, then plus 1 over 4, then again plus 1 over 4, which is going to give us what? 3 over 4. So this question is given. If you don't understand the meaning of the word at least, then you're going to be losing a focus on the part of it. So that is one key concept that I'm going to talk about. Then another one is one that you're saying, what is the probability of getting at most? At most. At most, let's say at most one head, one tail. At most one tail. So when you say the one at most, this one is the ceiling, so it is meaning one and below. So this one is going to be one and below. That is another concept that you're supposed to be able to understand. So when you say at most, the probability of getting at most one tail is going to be given by what? At most one tail. This one is going to be given by at most one tail, so meaning it is one and below. So this one is going to be probability. Getting this one is going to be head tail, where you have one tail there. Or if not that way, the probability of getting tail head, which is at least, or that way, meaning none, or whereby you get the probability of getting at most one tail, so it is one and below. So, meaning probability again of head and tail. So, that here and head, there is no tail. That's what is the probability of getting at most one tail. So that is C. You said it's 1 and B. So it can be 1 or 0. Again, that one is a technique which you have said this one is going to be 1 over 4 plus 1 over 4, then plus 1 over 4, giving us what? 3 over 4. So those are the two terms that I want to emphasize. You're going to be seeing them in our more examples as we move on. So that is the first attention that I want to pay to you. So this is example number 1. So let's go to example number 2. And then we see the concept which is going to be tested there. So in our example number 2, we are told that a boy draws a fair coin and a regular tetrahedron with its four faces marked number 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then he's asking you, find the probability that he gets a 3 on a tetrahedron and a head on the coin. So that's what I'm saying, that the moment you see, we are having more than one event in this case. So again, for you to come up with the list of the possible number of outcomes is the concept that is making me to emphasize in the concept of the trade diagram. Because remember, here you have a coin and you have a die, but this time it's not having the six side, because you have been told it's a tetrahedron. So tetra means four. So in order for you to come up with the probability you can have, the two events are very independent. The result of a coin does not have any relationship with the result of a die. So meaning that the two events are independent. And if they are independent, then you can be able to see. If you draw the die, what is your result you're going to get? So you can have your diagram like this one. You say here, you know, you have a coin. And when you have a coin, you have two outcomes. These two outcomes here is a head, a tail. This one is 1 over 2. Then this one is 1 over 2. Then you have that one for the die. You can have the 4. That you can get 1. You can get 2. You can get a 3. You can get a 4. So this one is going to be 1 out of 4. This is 1 out of 4, 1 out of 4, and also 1 out of 4. Then again, in the other one, you can have this one. Speed case again, you can have 1, 2, 3, and 4. So that here is possible outcome it can be. The chance can be either you get a head and a 1, or you get a head and a 2, or you get a head and a 3, or you get a head and a 4. Or you get a tail and a 1, then you get a tail and a 2, or a tail and a 3, then again a tail and a 4. So this one is 1 over 4 again, this is also 1 over 4, then this one is also 1 over 4, this is 1 over 4. So in total you're having how many? You're having 8 possible number of the outcome. That's why I'm insisting that the tree diagram will be assisting you to come up with the list all possible outcomes that you are going to be having. So in this case, the examiner is telling us, write the probability, number 1. You are told to write the probability of getting, write the probability of getting a 3 on a tetrahedron and a head on the coin. So the probability of getting a 3 and a what? 3 and a head. On a coin. So meaning that which is that term, whereby you get a 3 and a head. So you can see this one. You get a head and 3. So because the two of them are going to be independent, then you multiply the probability. So the probability of getting a head is what? It's 1 over 2. It's going to be the probability of getting a 3 multiplied by the probability of getting a head. So what is the probability of getting a 3 and a head? This one is going to be, for you to get a 3 is 1 over 4, and for you to get a head is 1 over 2. So when you multiply them, what are you going to see? In this case, you're going to see your answer is 1 over, this one is going to be 1 over 8. So that's the concept that I'm trying to talk about. So that is my explanation here. So we are saying these events are independent, meaning the occurrence of one event does not have any relationship with the occurrence of the other. So you can look to internalize what you're saying, that the probability of getting ahead is a half, while the probability of getting a three is 1/4. So therefore, to get the two of them, it's going to be a half multiplied by 1/4. At the end of the day, you get your answer is going to be 1/8. That's what I'm talking about, the tree diagram. It assists you to come up with the least possible number of the outcome. So this one was concerning only the independent events. Let us see which another one is going to combine the two of them. That is the independent event and the mutual exclusive. Yeah, you're good to go. Number three, you can see what you're told, that a bag contains 8 black balls and 5 white ones. Then if 2 balls are drawn from the bag, 1 at a time, then find the probability of drawing a black ball and a white ball first without the replacement, then second with the replacement. Remember, without the replacement is where you remove it, then you bring it back. So meaning you are moving from the bag, you know the color, when you know the color, then you take it back. So it is not affecting the total. But with the replacement, without the replacement is where you take the color, you don't take into the bag. But then in part B, we are saying with replacement, it's whereby you note the color, then you take it back. And if you're not told, then probability is usually without replacement. So if the examiner does not specify when you're supposed to take it without replacement, to that content, I'm going to emphasize it on my next lesson. So for the time being, you have your exercise 8.3 on page 169. You can attend question 1 and then question 2. Then we meet on the Google Classroom for that assignment. Now you keep safe at home. Otherwise, do have a good day and have a nice moment. With those few remarks, I am out.